Welcome. I am Vicky. You are watching Vicky Engineer. If you are into electrical designing or into home or space designing or into interior design or architecture, then this video is for you.
In 100 by 40 channel, how many 1.5 cables or how many Cat 6 cables or Cat 5 cables go through that? Then part of calculation is basically it's a calculation of cross-sectional area. It's a 100 by 40 pathway. Then we are carrying the, suppose we have to carry Cat 5 cables. How many number of Cat 5 cables can go through that? As you know, 100 by 40 equals 4000 square mm. If a Cat 5 cable is normally 9 mm in dia, it's varying from 8.5 to 9.5 inch. On an average, it's a 9 mm dia. Then our channel gets 4000 square mm. Then what next? It's always allowable if it is a 4000 square mm cross sectional area. It's always allowable 40%, not more than 40% that space of that space. What it comes for? If 4000 multiplied by 40, it will come around 1600 square mm. Understand? This case up to 1600 square mm, we can pass the cables on through that, not more than that. This is first point. Then what second point comes for? In 1600 mm, how many cables can go through? That is normally 1600 divided by 28 is 9 mm diameter cable stands for 28 square mm cross sectional area. Understand? Then we get, you please calculate on, actually right now I don't have calculator, you calculate 1600 by 28, whatever it comes, calculator.
If you watching still, it's my gratitude. If you like seeing this type of content, then do hit the subscribe button and the bell icon near that. And don't forget to like and share this video so that I can reach you faster with this type of content. So let's tune in to the video.
Then you get how many cables can pass through that. Understand? If you have any doubt regarding that, let me know in the comment. I'll let you know this. No hassle in that, no issue. You let me know if you are having doubt in this explanation. Next is, as you know, this is a very long process. It will take at least 2 minutes to calculate. If you are on site or anything, or you are on a designing table in front of you having a client, you can't take this much time to let him know or let her know what cables can go through that. Either you must have experienced, certainly you can say, if it's a 100 by 40 channel, maximum 27 to 28 cables can go through. Why I told this? How I came to 27 to 28? Because I have worked on that field. I have that experience. I can suddenly say maximum 28 to 27, maximum 29 cables can go through a 100 by 40 channel. But you are not into that, you are not experienced in that, you can say. What to do in that case? One more thing. Remember, sit quietly and remember the things. If you don't have bar, you are running or you are doing anything, at least bring your some spare time, pick a pen and paper and note down it. First, I talked about the area, that is in square mm. Since cables are coming in mm, the area comes in square mm.
If you watching still, it's my gratitude. If you like seeing this type of content, then do hit the subscribe button and the bell icon near that. And don't forget to like and share this video so that I can reach you faster with this type of content. So let's tune in to the video.
Next, one more word you might have heard or might have known, perimeter. Like in a square, there is a diameter, like in a radial cable or a circular thing, there is a diameter. Like if that is a square or rectangular or any shape, then it comes to perimeter. Perimeter is the outer surface. You can say if 4 by 3
there is a rectangle, the perimeter will be 4 plus 3 plus 4 plus 3. That is 2 multiplied by 4 plus 3. That is 4 plus 3 is 7 multiplied by 2. It's normally 40. This is the perimeter. In a thumb rule, basically I am saying a thumb rule, you mostly, I can say accurate, but mostly 90% you can get the same result. Again, we will take the same example. Suppose the ratio is angle is 100 by 40. What is the perimeter then? 100 plus 40, 140 multiplied by 2, it comes to 280. Understand? Then what is the diameter of that cable? Suppose the same cable we will take for example 9 mm. Right? Here we get 280, here we get 9 mm. We will divide 280 by 9. You will get around 280, 10 to 90, around 32, 33 I think you will get, 280 by 9. Better you calculate exactly, around 32, 33. Once you get, you have to divide the perimeter of the channel through which it will go and the cable to run through that, divided by only the perimeters. Right? Perimeter divided by diameter. Minus 10%. If it comes to 32, 33, anything, minus 10%, that comes to 3. The same result, what I said to you before, comes to 27 to 28. This way you can calculate how many cables can go through what ratio channel.